Alrighty.
Hey guys.
How's it going?
Welcome. We are back.
We are back. We don't even know how to do our intro again. I'm Julie, of course.
I'm Richie.
And we're back with horrible movie reviews. Tonight, and Contrary Chicken.
Yeah, can't we ever forget you, Contrary Chicken? No, I didn't think so, baby.
We are back with The Legend of Hell House.
Yeah, 1973.
And Roddy McDowall is in this movie. You know who Roddy McDowall is?
Yeah, I think he was in Overboard.
He was in...
Planet of the Apes.
Caesar, my favorite character. Planet of the Apes.
Cool.
He did an amazing job.
Yeah.
And he also played Caesar's son later.
Hmm.
So, it's really cool.
I think I remember him from Overboard.
It's been so long since I've seen Overboard.
I think he was the waiter on the yacht, I think. Roddy McDowall, Overboard. Okay, good.
Planet of the Apes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. So I also think that they remade Legend of Hell House in the 90s with, I get them confused. There was The Haunting, and there was House on Haunted Hill.
I think you're thinking of House on Haunted Hill, maybe.
Yeah, so this is...
Because I have never seen any remake of The Legend of Hell House. We were watching this on Netflix, by the way. It's 95 minutes. But it says like an hour and 34 something.
Yeah.
So
neither one of us have seen this.
No,
so
I don't even know what it's about.
Hopefully, if it's anything like Legend of Hill House, then I think I have an idea.
Maybe. I don't know.
Because in that movie, spoiler alert. In that movie, I'm pretty sure six people go for like a sleep study. And the people didn't tell them that the house is haunted, so they have to...
See how they react?
Yeah, exactly. Or that was The Haunting. See, I confuse them.
That
help me in the comments.
Sounds like a lawsuit waiting to happen.
Yeah, I remember Catherine Zeta-Jones.
You're thinking of The Haunting.
Okay.
Yes, I think so.
And then there was a movie that Tim Curry did where he was making fun of... He was in a movie where... It was making fun of it. I think it was Scary Movie 2 is what he did to make fun of that movie, part of it. He's taking videos of all the hot girls, you know, I'm like, ooh. Like he's supposed to be using it for research, but he wasn't. So. His own research.
Yeah, for further study. Okay.
So
we are going to watch this movie.
We're going to watch it, and then we'll tell you if you should watch it.
Yes.
And Chicken's going to watch it with us.
Maybe.
Well, she doesn't think she is, but she's going to.
Yes.
She doesn't agree, see? So. Okay.
Alrighty, stay tuned.
We'll be right back.
Okay, we just finished the movie. Why were they there to begin with? I had something to do with money. $100,000.
Yeah, to get money, to get paid individually by the religious guy at the beginning, I think, in the church.
The dude in the wheelchair.
In the wheelchair.
Yeah. Okay, so I have to admit, yes, it did scare the crap out of me in certain parts. And it was... I thought it was pretty good. And then the end happened, and it's like... Oh, I guess it's like when you see a magic trick. When it's done, when you see how it's actually done, it's like...
Mm-hmm.
Oh, so this isn't special anymore.
Yeah.
He was... spoiler alert.
You all should know, this is the spoiler time.
Mm-hmm.
Only watch this after you've watched the movie.
He ended up being a 4'9" old guy.
That looked like Ian McKellen.
On an extreme diet, I guess. And it wasn't several entities, it was just him being... real egotistical, I guess. And possessing cats. And
possessed cats, which I think there were a couple scenes in this that Scary Movie 2 took and made fun of.
I don't know.
Which he hasn't seen. Which the cat attack scene, then the having sex with a ghost scene.
There's the entity, though.
And the entity, yeah.
That was, yeah. The part where, like, the Miss Tanner walks in there and like he sees something in the bed that was just like
Will I ever watch this movie again, folks out there in YouTube world? No.
No, not when you know now. Now that we know. It was filmed really great, though. I really loved.
Great films, really unique sets. Shots and sets and costumes and
music.
Dialogue and the music. Mm-hmm. So all that was really positive. But it was,
yeah, even though it was over the top, it was. I enjoyed it.
Yeah.
Immensely.
So, what do we give it? Out of 10, what do you give it?
I'm gonna give it a 7.
Wow, okay.
Just because I really loved, the actors, and I loved the sets, and I loved how it was filmed, definitely, for sure. For just the classic nature of it all, and Roddy McDowall.
Yeah, maybe I was too premature with the
giving it a 4.
Because endings are really important to me, like ending and staying power and lasting and me wanting to watch it again. And I don't want to watch it again. And I didn't like the ending. So.
Well, yeah, the ending was kind of crappy, but at the same time, it's like, well, this thing that's really huge and scary, he was trying to be huge and scary even in real life, but he really wasn't, and he...
Okay, that makes sense now.
Yeah, and it's like...
A bully could shut him down.
Exactly.
Yeah, okay, that makes more sense. Mm-hmm. Even if I could be talked into a 6, we're still talking a D, even with your 7. 13 divided by 2 is 6.5.
Well, give it whatever you want.
That's horrible movie reviews, give it a D.
Your own personal opinion is what matters. I just wait till the camera's off and I'll bully you into an 8.5.
Does that mean we have to watch it again?
No, we'll have to watch something else now because I'm still pretty terrified.
Yeah, we'll watch something that's fun that you'll like.
Yeah.
Maybe I can talk you into watching Funny Farm.
Someday. It's funny.
It's hilarious.
Okay, yes.
Okay, we'll do a review on Funny Farm if I can convince her to watch it. Mm. Okay, guys.
Thanks for watching.
Thank you for watching. We'll see you next time.
The Legend of Hell House.
Legend of Hell House.
Mm. Bye. See ya.